Chapter 4, Penance. So I noticed we didn't have an interlude 3 between the chapters. That was Hal. Twig Hal. Okay. Can I just walk around again? I don't have to, collect things.
Things went swimmingly for the first few days of the beachside trip, no bad puns intended, and Emily was enjoying every minute of it. Sometimes I worried that I may have created a slight loner of a kid, given how happy she was to play by herself, how proficient she was at finding her own entertainment.
It's always a good thing, because people come and go. You'll always have yourself. Self-sufficiency is a great thing. Anything to collect
this
here?
This isn't to say that there weren't other children at the retreat with whom she was willing to briefly associate, but she didn't seem overly fussed if their parents had to take them home that same evening. She was happy either way. I guess I shouldn't have been surprised, given that she was an only child, and that she was no stranger to the idea that people might temporarily inhabit her life, only to depart shortly afterward.
Right.
Perhaps I'd raised her a little too well in that department.
Well, it was because her mother left, you know, so... Mothers aren't permanent. What the hell can be permanent, right? You tend to look at things that way. Oh, wow. Okay, so now we are at a beach. Good. Oh.
In the meantime, I was having my own version of a good time. Freed from the shackles of a more polite existence, I found little reason not to drink the days away, and the nights even more so. I know that wasn't the plan, but anyway. I met some new friends, and even made the acquaintance of a very lovely, very single woman 5 years my junior. A woman so charming that even Emily seemed to take a slight shine to her. Things were definitely looking up. Then came the day of the tragedy.
Tragedy? Day of the tragedy. Well, this guy certainly struggled through his life, and so has his little girl. Oh! He's gonna find the life preservers this time. Did she drown? Or the lady drowned? Oh, I cannot go in the water. No fade to white this time. Nice. I was observing the patterns of the birds, not the same as in the first bottle. Wow. Could be 6 episodes, guys. Enough to make its own playlist? Get out. Because I probably put in the playlist with the first game. I didn't even have to jump on that one. With the buoy over in the distance. Just looking all around for more life preservers. Wait. We found the other one over there? Or over here? It was getting darker? No. It's getting darker and lighter. That's where I came from, right? I think. I don't think I can climb up there. Unless you know I'm gonna try, don't you? Okay. So pretty. Alright, tell us about the day of the tragedy. We'll head this way. So glad that twig crap is over. Thought I'd never finish it. There's some kind of pavilion over here. And a little dock. Stuff to see. That's another preserver. I see it. Anything in this? Here for anything tucked away. See, it doesn't say. Yeah, we don't have to collect them. It doesn't say 2 of 5 or however many. That was different. Oh, cannot go. On over here. The water is really well done.
In the early evening, 2 days after meeting the woman,
I was
enjoying her company and that of some fellow adults, while my daughter enjoyed the water mere meters away from us. I say mere meters, but she must have started to drift further out without my noticing. A fact hardly surprising, given that my advanced state of inebriation limited my focus to one subject at a time, at best. And given that the woman was the greater novelty at the moment, she was the one stealing the bulk of my attention at the time. This attention was quickly divided, however, when I heard my daughter scream.
Not good. I don't like where this is going. Meaning the story, not the beach.
It's strange the sudden clarity one can experience, the moment one realizes that something they love is in danger. I leapt to my feet and caused all manner of calamity as I scrambled to free myself from the tiny maze of tables and chairs that surrounded us. Somewhere behind me, another man from our entourage was rushing to join me, but I was quicker to reach the waterside and wade frantically in, shouting my daughter's name.
So, is this the spot where she died? I think there's another fire thing. Life preserver, which glows red, but is not fire. Well, we can go up here, can't we? would love it. No, not exactly. No. Look at the shadows from the birds. Very nice. Yeah, I'm a bit afraid for where this story is going. She's how old at this point again? I forget. Why did that frighten me?
I couldn't actually see her at first, then glimpses only of her hands and arms as they flailed above the water. All thoughts of my own current capacity to swim were tossed aside, and I launched myself into the ocean, fingers first. I'm not even sure if I was swimming in the correct direction the whole time, but my body knew it had to press on, irrespective. Something inside my burning brain told me that as long as I pushed myself forward, I could aid my daughter. By the mere fact of willing myself to be her savior, that was what I would somehow become. Her body was never found.
Oh my god.
Mine somehow made its way back to the beach before collapsing, face down, so I'm told, into unconsciousness.
That's horrible. Yeah, the feeling was headed this way, that she was dead too. Sheesh. How do you just go on after that? How do you do it? This. Oh, is it moonlight reflecting sunlight? That's I have nothing to say about that. That's incredibly sad. Is that supposed to be a person's head floating above the water? I wish I could zoom in. Or a bottle. I'm not sure. Was it one of those birds? It doesn't look like one of those birds. But I don't know. So incredibly sad, wow. And you thought the first bottle game was depressing. That was only the warm-up. Now that's a buoy, I know that. What else is to say after this, dude? You make this pilgrimage every year.
I cannot say with any confidence whether I could have saved Emily, sober or not. But I blame the drink nonetheless. And most of all, I blame myself.
Yeah, that's all you can blame. Yourself.
Who am I kidding? A bottle can't be blamed for its actions any more than a rifle can be.
Exactly.
It was my weakness, my fault, and my fault alone, that I became a man so wretched that he failed to notice his own daughter struggling with the evening tide. My last-minute delusions of heroism count for nothing. I simply was not there for my only child when she needed me the most.
That is the bitter truth. Abso-friggin-lutely. Wow. Almost 3 hours. Let's check up here first, I guess. Instinctively trying to duck from the waves. Or dodge them, rather. Does it sound like those birds are laughing their asses off? It's not funny, you jerks. Let's go see if there's a life preserver tucked back here. Oh, not seeing anything, and I can't go up there.
Can I tell myself I was a good father? No, but I did try, more than my own father ever did. That said, the acorn doesn't fall far from the tree, and I can't deny the blood that runs through my veins. But I've punished myself plenty, and I've improved my ways. I don't drink anymore, and every year I make this pilgrimage to prove this fact to my daughter.
Moving a little late, aren't you? What else can you do? Is this our final destination up in here? There's a bottle up there, isn't there? Floating. Huh. Can't strafe.
I've another dozen unopened bottles where that came from, so my penance is far from over. I'm slowly learning to forgive myself, and I can only ask you, Emily, to forgive me also. You were the most vivid reminder I had left of your mother. Now that you're both gone, I... Well, let's just say that I keep to myself these days. It's better that way.
Damn.
all that I can do is be the best teacher that I can and give other people's children the best opportunities that life has to offer. I'm so sorry I couldn't do that for you. Farewell, my little Mimi. Sleep peacefully. Daddy loves you. Always.
Oh. Alright, that got me. Thanks for watching, guys. Hope to see you guys in another Let's Play. That hit me. Oh my god. Always seek adventure.